Hi, welcome to another video. Since the PSLE oral is just around the corner, I would just like to take the opportunity to make a quick video to discuss about the common mistakes that students make when taking the PSLE oral examination. Now, my name is Darren and I'm the English tutor from EnglishTuition.org. Now, during the actual PSLE exam, students are given 5 minutes preparation time and then another 5 minutes examination time. So the 5 minutes prep time can help the students calm their nerves. Okay, so they should make full use of this 5 minutes prep time to try and do two things. One, they should try and pronounce the difficult words that they see in the reading passage repeatedly, so that this will help to improve their fluency, so that when they read, they do not hesitate that much. They do not stop and say, hey, this is a 3 or 4 syllable words, I have to pause and slowly read through the words. So if you're not practiced during the prep time, this can actually help them to pronounce the words better. Okay, and then the other thing they can do is to brainstorm for ideas as to what are the possible conversation topics that may come up during the exam itself. So make full use of the time and do not daydream. Now, the second mistake, of course, after the prep time, okay, it's time for them to take the exam. So they walk up to the examiner and some students just sit down without greeting the examiners. Now, why is it important to greet the examiners? Now, you want to leave a favorable impression, okay, for the examiners, you want to be polite. And another thing is that once you start greeting the examiners, that kind of establish some kind of a relationship with the examiner, and it can help to reduce the nervousness a little bit, right? And then when it comes to reading the reading passage, that's the third mistake that the students make, is that when they see words they are not familiar with, they skip the words completely. That means they just don't bother to read the word and then just move on reading the rest of the passage. Right? What students should do is to try to use the syllables and try to pronounce the word. At least if you try to pronounce the word, there is some effort there and there's a chance that the students may still get the pronunciation correct. So then he or she will not be penalized for skipping the word completely. If a student skip the words completely, then for sure there will be some penalty, right? Because we should not skip words when reading, right? It's part of the reading examination. And when it comes to reading, many students that I teach, and in fact that's from my observations, that many Singaporean students or local students tend to read in a rather flat tone. So that's like reading from the text itself and without any investment of emotions in it. So as human beings, we want the story or the passage to become alive when we read. So the way to do that is to read in a more emotional tone, invest in a certain degree of emotions into the reading. For example, you have somebody shouting for help, instead of going like help, help, help me, right? If the passage puts some exclamation mark down there, then you should go like help, help, help me, right? You do not have to shout very loud at the examiner, okay, but you do have to have some kind of emotion to show that you understand that this is the emotion that the correctors are experiencing, and then it will certainly helps the reading a lot, right? And another common mistake, many students fail to pronounce the N words like K, T, S, and some students even go as far as to forget or ignore the ED sound, the past tense, completely, right? For example, one third, that's the ED sound, they just go like once, right? Or one, even worse, without the T, right? One and once, right? So make sure that the student pronounce all the N words correctly and accurately, and it will make the reading sound a lot more sharp and crisp. And the next mistake that students make is that they treat conversational questions as comprehension questions, right? So if you're answering a comprehension questions, of course you are trying to just give a one sentence or two sentence answers to the examiner. But bear in mind that this is an oral exam and this is not a comprehension paper. So it's a conversation paper. In other words, you're expected to try and make a conversation with the examiner based on the question that was given to you. And if you have more content to say, please continue to speak, right? Even when the examiner keeps quiet, right? Because the examiner, bear in mind, examiner has to test, okay, many students, and the examiner may be very tired and may not wants to give so many prompts. So if the examiner just sits there, don't just stop with a 1 to 2 sentence answers, right? Try to come up with your own content and make a good conversation from there. Of course, if you pause a lot, okay, that is considered as hesitations, and examiners do try to help by giving the appropriate prompts. But bear in mind that the more prompts that the examiner gives, the more likely that you will get penalized, because that actually affects your fluency, right? You should come out with the content by yourself as much as possible with minimal prompts. That's how you can do well for the conversation component. And some students I know, when I practice with them the oral questions, they like to use dead end answers to an open ended questions. For example, if you get a question like, do you enjoy playing sports? Why or why not? And then they give answers like, no, I don't enjoy playing sports at all. I don't do any sport. Yeah, that's it, right? So that's a dead end answer, and you're working yourself into a dead end, and you can't carry on from there, right? So try to use more open ended answers. Okay, to these questions, right? You say, you might say that, right, I do not do any exercise at the moment, but I understand that there are some benefits as to exercise, and I look forward to maybe pick up a new sport or hobby in the near future, and here are some of the benefits, and so on and so forth. So that gives you more room to discuss the topic at hand. So do not use dead end answers, because that will stop you dead in your tracks, and then you will not know how to continue, right? So to sum up the video, oral skills can be developed through daily practice. It's not too late to start now if you're not using English at all, okay, at home or in school. Okay, we are bilingual schools, right? So students will have to take two languages, right? Chinese and exam. So don't just use one language. If you just use English, you don't use Chinese, that's not good. If you just use Chinese, you don't use practice your English, then you are effectively becoming more and more monolingual instead of bilingual, right? So you should be able to effectively use both languages at the same time. So you should find the opportunities in your daily life to use these languages, whether at home or in school, whether you're talking to your parents or talking to your friends in school, right? Speak more and speak well, and then learn through self-correction. So don't be afraid to make mistakes. Don't be embarrassed when you say the wrong word or pronounce the wrong word. So some students, instead of pronouncing the word brochure correctly as brochure, they go like brochure, right? Then that creates some laughs, within the family, and then I think that's fine, because then people will correct you, right? That's how we learn. People say, hey, you are saying the wrong word, that's brochure, that's not pronounced as brochure, right? And then you learn from there. So that's how we learn to improve our oral skills, without having to just come for tuition lessons and sit in a formal environment, then we learn. That's not how it works, right? So oral skills is a skill, and the more we practice, the more we can develop the skill, the better we become. So yeah, that's the end of the video. So if you like the video, like the content, just give it a thumbs up. Dislike it, for whatever reason, give it a thumbs down, and let me know why in the comment section below. If you like to see more videos just like this one, subscribe to my YouTube channel or follow me on my Facebook page. I'll leave the links in the video description below. I'll see you around soon. Bye.